Kampala and Diocese. Monsignor Richard Kayondo, Vicar General of Lugazi Diocese. Mother Cecilia Njeli, Superior General of the Little Sisters of St. Francis. Sister Miriam Davan, representative of the Superior General of the Franciscan Missionary Sisters for Africa. Reverend Father Edward Sekamanja, the Episcopal Vicar for the cause of beatification and canonization of Mother Kevin. Reverend Fathers, religious brothers and sisters, officials from the central government and Uganda Kingdom, all our distinguished guests, friends of Mother Kevin and the Little Sisters of St. Francis. Good evening to you all. We are gathered here to hear about a gallant Franciscan missionary woman, Mother Mary Kevin Kearney of the Franciscan Missionary Sisters for Africa. Very briefly, I want to say that Mother Kevin, about whom much is going to be said later, now ranks among the servants of God in the Catholic Church. The cause for her beatification and canonization started on 6th November 2016 in Lubaga Cathedral. At the diocesan level, the process of establishing facts about her life was closed on 17th November 2018 in Lugazi Cathedral. In order for Mother Kevin to be beatified and canonized, the Church requires a miracle, the most convincing being one of instant cure of a medically proven impossible case. As Little Sisters of St. Francis and the Franciscan Missionary Sisters for Africa, the daughters that Mother Kevin founded, we request you to pray to Mother Kevin using the official prayer for favors and miracles. Her beatification and canonization is being sought to manifest the triumph of God's grace in her life, and she also will become a beacon of holiness of life to the followers of Christ. At the same time, we turn to all people who will to support the cause expenses incurred both locally and at the Vatican by making some contributions financially, morally, and spiritually. With that brief introduction, may I take this opportunity to thank you for sparing your precious time to come and attend this occasion, which is very dear to us, the Little Sisters of St. Francis of Assisi and the Franciscan Missionary Sisters for Africa, and the Association of the Friends of Mother Kevin and the Little Sisters. I have the pleasure this evening to introduce to you the speaker who is going to present the Mother Kevin Inaugural Memorial Lecture. He is none other than Professor George Dabea, born in 1934 and was a ward of Mother Kevin Kearney from age 3 to age 16. During these years, he lived in Kokonjeru under the care of Mother Kevin. He has a long experience in the medical field, in which he qualified as a doctor in 1960 at Makerere University. In 1967, he specialized in medicine and cardiology in England and also pursued further studies in the same field at Hammersmith Hospital in England and Edinburgh in Scotland. He returned to Uganda and served at Makerere University as Professor of Medicine and as the head of department. In 1982, due to the unrest in Uganda, he moved out and served overseas for 24 years. In 2006, he returned and joined the Sambia Hospital as senior consultant in medicine and cardiology. Professor Kabera was instrumental in initiating the Uganda Martyrs University postgraduate medical school at Zambia, and was the first dean from 2006 to 2016 when he stepped down, but continued to serve in this capacity as a caretaker dean until the hospital will appoint a new dean. To date, he works in the Department of Medicine at Zambia Hospital as a consultant in medicine and cardiology. Professor Kabera was a key player in the foundation of the Association of the Friends of Mother Kevin and the Little Sisters in 2008. He was the founding chairman until 2017, when he handed over to the current chairperson, Madame Josephine Nabumolo. He still sits on the committee as an ex officio. Professor Kabera has published widely in the medical field, especially on heart diseases. More importantly, he was invited by the late Emmanuel Cardinal Suga to make a presentation on the Catholic Church and the medical services in Uganda as a centenary review in 1979. He was also invited to make a similar presentation in 2003 on the topic Zambia Hospital through 100 years. Together with Sister Pauline Namutu, Little Sisters of St. Francis, at the Diamond Jubilee of the Little Sisters in 1999, he presented a review of the Institute of the Little Sisters of St. Francis. Both reviews were produced in a book entitled The Catholic Church in Africa, written during the pontificate of Pope Francis and published in November 2015. Among many other public activities Professor Kabera was involved in are the following. He was associated with the Mother Hospital as founding chairman of the Board of Governors from 1977 to 1979. In 1982, the late Emmanuel Cardinal Suga invited him to form a two-man committee with Professor Charles Owendi to advise on the future of the Zambia Hospital. Professor was the founding chairman of the Uganda Joint Medical Stores, appointed by the late Emmanuel Cardinal Suga in 1979. So my dear brothers and sisters, this is the man who has been asked by the Association of the Friends of Mother Kevin and of the Little Sisters of St. Francis to present the Mother Kevin inaugural memorial lecture. He weighs heavily, but I personally find him a very simple man, approachable and kind. I want to believe that Professor Kabera must have taken a good dose of Mother Kevin's compassion and humility. I wish you good luck. Thank you.
The chief guest, Honorable Justin Kasule, remember, our host, His Grace, the Archbishop, Cyprian Kizito, here represented by the Monsignor Kasibante, all distinguished guests here tonight, protocol observed. It's with great pleasure that I stand here before you in gratitude for being honored by the Association Friends of Mother Kevin and the Living Sisters of St. Francis, to be asked to present this inaugural lecture of Mother Kevin. I choose to start this exercise by citing two passages from the Acts of the Apostles, which I think are pertinent to our evening tonight. The first is from the Apostle Paul in the Jerusalem Bible, Corinthians 1, chapter 13, verses 1 to 3. I quote, "If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have a gift of prophecy, understanding and all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all his fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever." Close the quote. The second passage is James, again from the Jerusalem Bible, chapter 2, verses 14 to 17. "Take the case, my brothers, of someone who has never done a single good act but claims that he has faith. Will that faith save him? If one of the brothers or one of the sisters is in need of clothes and has not enough food to live on, and one of you says to them, 'I wish you well, keep yourself warm and eat plenty,' without giving them these bare necessities of life, then what good is that? Faith is like that. If good works do not go with it, it is quite dead." Close the quotation. We are assembled here tonight to remember and pay tribute to Mother Kevin, a human who lived amongst us, a giant who was yet a little woman, a man who left permanent footprints on this land, changed the destiny of many in our society, the outcome of which have relegated to us a continuing and enduring legacy, an indelible stamp for many generations to come. Part 12 in Uganda, the East, Central and South Africa, even the world beyond, made a great impact on the course of social development in these lands. This is the subject of our assembly here tonight. Inevitably, while we pay tribute to her, it is right and proper that we should remember the other stakeholders who were then on the scene, whose joint interaction and collaboration made this remarkable success story of evangelization and social development unmatched by quotes from higher levels of the church, unmatched anywhere else in the world. Close the quote. The stakeholders included our forebearers who had the vision and foresight to lay the ground for the opening of the land to religion, education, and development. We reflect on the Sekabakas who had established an organized framework of government in this land that left Western explorers and visitors in utter amazement that they should find such social order quite akin to theirs, deep in the hinterland of what was then conceived as the Dark Continent. Specifically, in this respect, we commemorate Sekabaka Mutesa I, who made an earnest petition to Henry Morton Stanley to appeal to England to send missionaries and educators to come and enlighten his people. The explorers themselves, I'm glad to say that Sekabaka Mutesa's first and also Mutesa second is represented here tonight by no other than Narimia Kagere Bale. Could you clap for her? The explorers themselves, who acted as intermediaries, the churches which responded to the call, the political stakeholders who created an auspicious environment for churches to play their roles, all this laid the foundation bequeathed to us, which it behooves us to pass on uncompromised to posterity. We thank and glorify the magical Creator who caused everything to happen and continues to give us succor. Since the early explorers, colonialists, business prospectors, and missionaries made their debut in the exciting journey to Uganda, which they called their promised land, a lot of water has flowed under the bridge. Unbelievable transformation in the landscape and the communities dwelling in it have taken place now nearly two decades beyond a century. Religion is deeply embedded, education and social evolution and advancement of social services, political maturation and structural development all occurred as a storm, but a bewildering speed, and hitherto unparalleled, and would be beyond the belief and imagination of Speke and Grant, Burton and Henry Morton Stanley, and all the early explorers and visitors who were there to visit again. Among the contributions of the many players on the scene, one that has been most remarkable and has received consistent or even unanimous approbation is the unbelievable work of missionaries of all different orientations, most notable of which was that of the Franciscan Sisters of St. Mary's Abbey. These sisters were brought by the biblical bishop Henry Anron in the year 1903. The sisters who came to do missionary work in Africa were in later days, that is, in 1952, granted permission by the Holy See to constitute themselves as an exclusive missionary congregation with its own superior, its autonomous governance and constitution, and they became the Franciscan Missionary Sisters for Africa. We salute their representatives present here tonight. Give them a clap. The other offspring of these Franciscan sisters
was that through the congregation of the Little Sisters of St. Francis, the permanent legacy bequeathed to us by the Franciscan Missionary Sisters of Africa. We hail their large numbers present here tonight, another clap. At the head of the pioneer Franciscan Sisters was Mother Paul Murphy, an American sister, who was sent with five others to Uganda to participate in the mission of the Melville Fathers at the invitation of Bishop Anon. These sisters she was later, Mother Paul was later in 2019 succeeded by the head of the team, succeeded by her deputy, Sister Kevin. It is with the compelling and propulsive and throbbing leadership of Mother Kevin that the country witnessed the breathtaking whirlwind establishment of convents, schools, hospitals, and other social services that took everybody as a blizzard, as will be illustrated in the course of the evening. Most notably, it was the foundation of Mother Kevin in the year 1923 of the Congregation of the Little Sisters of St. Francis, which later in 1958 was also accorded by the Holy See the status of an independent diocesan congregation with complete autonomy and having its own superior general, council and constitution, that has left to posterity the most remarkable footprint in the Franciscan sisters in this part of Africa. It is against the backdrop of these breathtaking achievements, cognizant of the key role of Mother Kevin as prime mover, chief architect, and pilot of the two congregations of sisters referred to, that the association of friends of Mother Kevin and the Little Sisters of St. Francis decided to launch a Mother Kevin Memorial Lecture, the frequency of which is yet to be decided, with the objective of propagating her name, her work, her mission, and ensuring the survival of her initiative and endeavors through time. The practical focus of the association is to render support, material and otherwise, to the sisters, and thus empower them to successfully steer and discharge their apostolate, which embraces evangelization, teaching, healing, and rendering other noble acts of charity in their service to God's people, here and far and wide in the world, and to enable them to endure and survive the times of change of the times. Through networking and fundraising, the Friends' objective is to raise the resources and put them at the disposal of the sisters for their needs. In November 2018, the Association Council revisited the subject of the Memorial Lecture, and I was nominated for the task to deliver the inaugural lecture, which has brought us here tonight. The reason that I was contemporary to Mother Kevin's time, I lived at the Brooklyn General, I knew Mother Kevin, and was therefore most suited for the task. Having accepted
Having accepted the assignment, I went away reflecting on what knowledge I possessed about Mother Kearney. I lived there as her ward from age 3 to age 16 years. She served me breakfast and organized my education. Sometimes when she went to open new convents, like Kabule, Dabuni, Kikacha, I was in her company. Was that really enough to qualify me for the task? I'm afraid not. To meet the challenge, I resorted to the inner witnesses who shared Mother Kearney's lifestyle and whose recorded accounts are available. They say it all. In particular, I refer to three publications which give details about Mother Kearney. Two were written by Sister Mary Louise O'Hara of the Franciscan Sisters, and one by the Sister Mary John, a little sister of St. Francis. The latter having been one of the first six Ugandan pioneers to join the congregation of the Little Sisters of St. Francis when it was first formed in 1923. Starting with Sister Mary Louise O'Hara's publications, she was a remarkable resource